Over the last decade or so, there has been a rapid increase in the number of Muslims in South Korea. Many of the new reverts in the country are quite vocal about their religion on social media and have thousands of followers. One example is that of Safia Kang, who embraced Islam back in January 2015. In this video, we'll be going over her amazing story. So let's begin. So Safia Kang's first interaction with Islam came when, at the end of 2008, she started working at the Korean Muslim Federation, KMF. Before that, she had never been interested in any religion, including Islam, as nearly 50% of the population of Korea is atheist. Anyhow, Safia soon adjusted in KMF as an employee. Since it was basically a mosque, she made many Muslim acquaintances. She began hanging out with them and soon realized that she was able to feel a peace of mind, one she had never felt before. She felt like Islam is a true religion and the Islamic doctrine, all men are equal except God, particularly grabbed her attention. She was also greatly impressed by the way Muslims live, that they do not bother others and that Islam does not ostracize people from other faiths. Ultimately, after 8 years of working at the KMF, Safia was convinced that she wanted to spend the rest of her life as a Muslim. So in January 2015, she said her Shahada and became a Muslim, alhamdulillah. Proceeding forward with the story, as opposed to the cases of most reverts, Safia's family and friends reacted relatively well to her conversion to Islam. She says that her family respected her opinion, while her friends thought it was unusual. Moving on, adopting an Islamic lifestyle from being an atheist was, of course, quite challenging for Safia at first. She obviously couldn't bring changes to her habits overnight. It was also difficult for her to balance her Korean identity with Islam, since Korea's culture is dominated by strong Confucian ideas. If you're wondering who Confucius is, he was basically a philosopher and teacher who lived from 551 to 479 BCE and laid the foundation for much of the culture of ancient China. However, through unwavering faith in Allah, she was able to control herself and settle in as a Muslim. Interestingly, Safia had already experienced Ramadan with her Muslim colleagues before becoming a Muslim. She says that although it was hard for her to resist water at first, as the years went by, she felt the burden getting smaller. During her first Ramadan as a Muslim, Safia says that she was so touched that while breaking her fast with a date, she cried. She says that Ramadan is not just about fasting. It makes you feel at peace and happiness in your heart. Due to COVID-19, Safia felt sad because in Ramadan, she couldn't have iftar and tarawih prayer together with her Muslim sisters. However, she understands that it's for everyone's safety. Today, Safia still works at the KMF and also has her own halal restaurant named Manis Kitchen, where she serves Korean snacks to both Korean Muslims and Muslim travelers. She lives near Seoul Central Masjid, so it is much easier for her to live an Islamic life than other Muslims in Korea. There are many Muslims living in that area, so it's convenient for her to find halal food as well. As part of religious minority in Korea, Safia has received plenty of questions about extremism and hijab. Whenever she hears these misunderstandings, she tries to explain the real Islamic teachings to the concerned party. As a social media influencer, she has nearly 50,000 followers on Instagram, where she posts photos and videos of Islamic food, fashion, and cultural events. She says that her social media endeavors have helped bridge the gap between Korean and Muslim cultures in a more effective way. Safia says that becoming a Muslim feels like being born again. To all the Muslim brothers and sisters out there, she has a message. She says that although the coronavirus has worn us out, Allah Ta'ala will show us His mercy to stabilize our lives soon, inshallah.